Peace, peace, peace. 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 What's up, my sister? Azarel, Azazel. Peace and blessings. Yo, I've been going through a lot today, yo. I've been going through a lot. Thailand in the building. My people's from Thailand, always tuning in. What up? Share this video out. Anybody that's in Thailand, if you're overseas, let me know where y'all tuning in from. Come on, man. Let me know where y'all tuning in from. And please come to the YouTube channel. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, okay? And if you haven't signed up for the Patreon, please go to Patreon too. Please go to the Patreon, okay? The Sabir Bay Show Patreon. And you can also go to the Cash App, $Sabir Bay. Or if you have Zelle or PayPal, you can go to SabirBayRadio@gmail.com. Again, SabirBayRadio@gmail.com. is the Zelle and PayPal. The Cash App is $Sabir Bay. And if you want to join the Patreon, is the Sabir Bay Show. So if you want to join me on here, this is the link for the YouTube channel. Please subscribe to that channel. Please subscribe to the channel and please share it out right now. New York in the building. My sister Thomas Marie, what's up? Come on, let me know where y'all tuning in from. You was on fire yesterday. Brother, you have no idea. I'm just being careful about what Sabir Bay is saying. I'm just being careful. Because they like to cancel people. Come on, man. I know y'all heard what I said. Where y'all tuning in from? Come on, let's stop this. Hold on, we got to start this back up. Give me 1 second. I got to start my Facebook back up. Give me 1 second. We're not going to start till my Facebook get on. Okay, give me 1 minute. Minneapolis, what's up, LeWanda? I got to start my Facebook back up. If you don't like what I'm saying, it's easy to leave my feed. I'm so freaking serious. Because people be like, brother, you be giving up so much information for us for free, brother. Costa Rica, New Haven, Minneapolis, Toronto, Canada. Let's go. Come on, baby. Let's go. Give me 1 second. We're going to go back on Facebook. We're going to go back live.
They like to camp.
Okay. Hawaii, VA, what's up? Point Comfort, Virginia, what's up? Terry, what's up? Hey, you said my name correct. Really? LeWanda. Oh, I'm glad I said it right. I thought I had ADHD. Oh, you're messy, bruh. We say, oh, you're messy. What you mean, sis? What I'm messing, my hair messed up? Oh, my bun? Oh, my bun. Oh, my messy bun. Hold on, let's see if we can figure this one out. I got you now, sister. Get with me. I'm tired. Hold up. Is it, hold on, let me help y'all out. Because you know this stuff be in my hair. So it's kind of, this is not real, y'all. That's a wig. This is a wig, y'all. This is a wig. So listen, I want y'all to go to my Patreon, The Sabir Bey Show. So let me share something with you. I've been mad busy, right? I've been mad busy. Trying to go overseas, they put you through the ringer. I'm going to keep it a buck with y'all. They put you through the ringer. I'm like on some like real rap, and I am very hard to deal with. But they put you through the ringer. Now, I showed y'all I got a negative on the COVID test, right? So I can't make this up. I got a negative, right? So in Chicago, they're asking for people like to put a mask on. I swear to God, this is the day. Shout out to my brother Philip too, and Key. So I'm out here and they asked us to put a mask on. So I, no lie, I swear to God, I can't make this up. Anybody, if my brother Philip would tell you this, I did just like this. He said, okay, thank you. I just showed him my phone. I showed my cell phone that I had a negative, right? So, and it was like, okay, thank you. So as I'm getting everything together to grade leave, right? Do you know, and I want y'all to hear me, and I'm going to talk about this Jewish thing. I mean, you know, Africans, are they Jews? And the reason why, what I really, 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 really want to talk about, I can't post up. Are y'all following me? This is why I'm telling everybody to come to Patreon. Because what I really want to say, if I say it to you on this, they're going to block me. So y'all be careful with the words that I'm putting up here just to throw people off, because this stuff is real. So I posted up there, are the Africans Jews? Because that came up and the brother said the Africans were not Jews. The Africans were not Jews. If anybody know, they took my, you know, they stopped me for 90 days, I think, for going on my original page. My original page, Sabir Bey, and the Sabir Bey Radio. So it's that serious. I'm so serious. Okay? How they just going to, brother, you say how? This is not our platforms. And this goes for Umar Johnson too, because I hope you share this to Umar Johnson. Because this Negro said he don't allow white people on his platform. Tell Umar Johnson right now, share this with him. Nigga, it ain't your platform, Umar Johnson. YouTube is not your platform. It's not a black platform, Umar Johnson. Instagram, Umar Johnson, is not a black platform. Instagram, Facebook, YouTube is not black, Umar Johnson. So you don't dictate who to come on. So stop acting like you the King Kong conscious of something, because you're not the King Kong conscious of nothing. Just like Black Dot said. Black Dot said YouTube make niggas tough. Facebook's make niggas tough. If anybody wants to get at me, you can inbox me, DM me. Let me know what city or town or country you in, and we can meet up, because I'm in Chicago. So stop acting like you tough on social media, because none of you niggas are tough. That's real. Get that message. And if you didn't get it, rewind that mother freaking. Rewind it or confront me on my live. So I'm going to keep it a buck with y'all. So the Australian lady Cam on his platform. Exactly. But if Umar Johnson was educated on who the original Australians was or is to this day. See, y'all love sensationalism. Oh, it feels so good because he sounds so like a politician. Just go to the Sabir Bey Show Patreon. Look it up. The Sabir Bey Show Patreon. Niggas is crazy. Yeah, she was, you know what I mean? That's crazy. Yeah, he out of his goddamn mind. I hope y'all share this to him. And if he got an issue with Sabir Bey, he can come on my feed live. We can spar toe to toe on this motherfucker. I'm fine. Australian lady cameras. Yeah, man, this is crazy, man. He don't even know who he is. He running around calling himself black. It's the blackness, brother. It's the black. It's the black. This is the black or African channel. Shut the hell up. Miss me with that. Whatever, if anybody feels some type of way about me, I don't give a goddamn. Leave my feed. Y'all love that sensational bull crap. We ain't got time for that bull crap. We really don't. If you don't like it, leave it. Take any way you want to. So as I'm out here, because I wasn't going to do a video, he ain't coming on. I know he not. Niggas on it. Osad, yeah, Sabir, why we have inches coming on the feed, brother? I don't know, brother. Hey, I don't know, brother. Why he having inches? Nigga, I don't care. I'm fine. So as I was getting ready to go overseas, I got to fill out a bunch of pieces of paper right about now. I had got the test. The test came back negative. Then this bull crap came up and it said, now you have to, give me 1 second. You got to fill out a form when you go overseas now. They got to tell you what seat you sitting in. So let some of these Moors, don't lie, let them lie to you. This is the form you got to fill out. It's called a health form. After you get vaccinated, after you take the test, you got to fill this out. Whether you vaccinated or not, whether you are vaccinated or not, you have to fill this out. I only got the test done. The test. This is the swab they swabbed me with, and it's made in China. This is the swab, and I told them, let me keep this, right? It's made in China. They put it up your nose, not that far, but anywho. And I said, and it came back negative, right? So, you know, for the record, for just in case y'all, I told you I like to show and prove what I'm talking about. For the people that didn't see my video yesterday, and it does say Sabir Bey, so you cannot do this and also get on the plane. It comes back negative, right? Negative. Just the swab. And I told you I have not sat still, and I've been in almost every state. Every state, right? And I'm sitting up here now, I got to fill out this health form for them when you travel. They want to know your seat. Listen, if you plan on traveling overseas, I don't give a damn which way. If you got one of these Moors that talk that crazy stuff, believe me, you're going to have to do it. I'm going to keep it a buck with y'all. I'm going to keep it a buck. It took me a long time because anybody know me, I would have been gone. I would have been gone. Really been going, but it's all up. I know my health. I take care of my health. I don't eat the garbage. I don't eat the poison. I know y'all love y'all shrimps and lobsters and your beef and all of that. I got it. It's okay, but you got to deal with that. Cause the thing about it, you ain't never forever 21. So I've been not still since this took place. Since it took place, and I've been in almost every state. Every state. Next time y'all see me, I may be overseas. Just can't tell y'all when I'm leaving, though. Need help? Can you please help me? So I do one-on-ones. If you want to email me, you can email me at sabirbeyradio@gmail.com. What's up, my sister behind the mic? That is my sister right there. What up? So you can email me at sabirbeyradio@gmail.com. sabirbeyradio@gmail.com. Okay? All right? So we're going to have some fun. I did want to talk about some things, but it's like I got to be very careful about what I'm saying because sometimes I shoot myself in the foot. And I got to be careful because I got to, as soon as I turn around, y'all ain't got my back. I'll be standing by myself looking like this. That's the link. If you want to come on the feed, y'all, is right there. Sabir Tagetsu Bey. Hit that up. There it is. Share. My sister posted everything. Thank you, my sister. One-on-one speaking engagements. Let's get it popping. So please share this out. Please share it out. Please share it out. Okay. All right. The world is too vast to suffer in one place. Y'all can kill that noise. I'm going to say it again. The world is too vast to suffer in one place. My brother Madib is in. He's leaving Malaga, heading to Madrid. I don't get it. He's leaving from Malaga. I'm supposed to meet him in Cordoba, Spain. Cordoba, Spain. Y'all know where the big mosque is at? Y'all remember I took the picture there? Y'all remember the last time I was there? When I took the picture with the what you call SWAT sticker behind me? Praise the Lord, sister. How you doing? You there? Okay, she got to fix her mic.
I used to be a hey chap.
What up? Yeah, they put me. They put you through the ringer, boy. If you're trying to get about this mug, boy, they want to keep niggas here. Like my Umi said, the world is too vast to suffer in one place. And my brother Madib is actually on his way to Cordoba. And I'm a probably, I got my GoPro ready. I got my 360 GoPro ready. I got my camera. I don't know. Only time I would probably go live if I'm sitting in a hotel or somewhere. I don't know. But them things cost when you outside, boy. Them sense cards cost like a mug. So everybody's not going to get privileged to what I used to do. And on top of that, when you're out there, motherfucker, your phone get hot. Mm-hmm. That motherfucker get hot.
There's no luxury of free Wi-Fi, right?
Hey, hell no. People good over here. That's why I was laughing at Umar Johnson talking about this. This is for African people. Nigga, this is not even an African people's network, nigga.
That's his name.
No, but this is where we going at. This is where we'll be at. That's the mosque where I was at last time. That's in Cordoba, Spain. It's very huge. It looks like a football field.
That's pretty dope. It's kind of shaped like a key, you know, like where you put a key.
Who took the vaccine? Damn, they said somebody took the vaccine. If y'all took, I gotta be careful, but I didn't take it. That's all I gotta say. Let me shut up. You know, they might be watching. The nigga be throwing stuff out just to see, nigga. I gotta be careful, nigga.
Bait, throwing a little bait.
You know what I mean? Specify your travel from U.S. and U.S. is on the red list. No, it's not. Don't believe the hype. It's not. Don't believe the hype. So what we going to do, and this is, you see that same doorway? That's a damn lie. Who told you that? If I prove you wrong, you give me a $5,000. Whoever your fake ass is, give me $5,000. And I ain't got to lie about taking no shot, nigga, because I would never take a shot. Never. So if you can prove me wrong, I'll show you the data. Don't play with me, B. I'm not the one you want to play with. That's the problem with people. That's where you saw me sitting. That says Moore's doorway. So if you think you know me, bring it. Bring your evidence. If you think you know me. I can tell you a lot, but I can't tell you right now because niggas want you to put your foot in your mouth and be like, yo, we can't let that niggas go over here and start telling you black people in the States how this works. Mm-hmm. Let's go. Oh, let's go. They don't know me. They don't know me, sis.
The virus was fed to nearly 300. In 1950, the AIDS virus was fed to nearly 300,000 black youth in Africa in the form of an oral polio vaccine by Dr. Hilary Kaprowski, who is currently the director of biovirology at Thomas Jefferson University in Philadelphia. Today, a child dies every minute of HIV/AIDS in sub-Saharan Africa. In the U.S., biovirology at Thomas Jefferson University in Philadelphia. Today, a child dies every minute of HIV/AIDS in sub-Saharan Africa. In the U.S., African Americans represent 49% of all new AIDS cases. The globalists, the population controllers, the tax makers, dark nation depopulators, the Contra trainers, American Nazi bankers, the Tower bombers, right wing Al Qaeda sponsors, Hitler's accomplice, 9/11 mission accomplished. Free your conscience. In ghettos, they kill the prophets, the juggernauts, the alphabet cops, the CIA, FBI, the coca crops, imported to local blocks. The 5 years for the black to the month that the cracker got a powder pipe compared to a gram of rock. Got blacks at 50% of the prison pop. The whacking huts, the correction corporations, the International Planned Parenthood Federation, the forced abortion. forced sterilizations, the sons of Satan, Operation Depopulation. From 1924 to 1976, 32 states in the U.S. utilized eugenics programs to depopulate the country of so-called weak breeds who were downbreeding in 76. 32 states in the U.S. utilized eugenics programs to depopulate the country of so-called weak breeds who were downbreeding the American population. Some 65,000 black youth from public school districts throughout the country were given a biased IQ test. All who failed the test were sterilized against their or their parents' will. The diamond dealers, them choppers and baby killers, the oil drillers, black nation resource dealers, the truth concealers, suppression of true gorillas, Patrice Lumumba, Nkrumah, Lauren Kabila, the people traitors, poor population enslavers, the black slash brown slash yellow baby cremators, the black slash brown slash yellow unity haters, the red slash white slash blue liberty waivers, eugenicists, world imperialists, evolutionists, black moon pollutionists, the euthanizers, third world burst sterilizers, Nazi sympathizers, finances and arms suppliers, the nuke igniters, the World Health Organizers, the virus writers, smallpox, Ebola splices, the throne of serpents, the worst death deservers, the devil worship, more power for every murder. A 1996 expose by the San Jose Mercury News documented CIA involvement in a Nicaraguan drug ring which poured thousands of kilos of cocaine into Los Angeles African-American neighborhoods in the 1980s. Drug boss Danilo Blandon, now an informant for the DEA, acknowledged under oath the drugs for weapons deals with the CIA-sponsored Contras. The Club of Rome, World Bank to Skull and Bones, Alhamdulillah engraved in the Pope's throne, the camouflage, the right versus left mirage, wishing Kerry got naked to pleasure in the same lodge. The Reagan years, the luminous presidents, every since they've been facing the obelisk, the Kabbalist. Harry Potter is not a myth. This ain't on radio, but this that shit. The war on drugs has been a war on poor people, particularly poor urban African-American men and women. It's well documented that police enforcement of the new harsh drug laws have been focused on low-level dealers in communities of color.
Arrests
of African-Americans have been about 5 times higher than arrests of whites, although whites and African-Americans use drugs at about the same rate. African-Americans have been imprisoned in numbers even more disproportionate than their relative arrest rates. It is estimated that in 1994, on any given day, one out of every 128 U.S. adults was incarcerated, while one out of every 17 African-American adult males was incarcerated. The differential in sentencing for powder and crack cocaine is one glaring example of institutionalized racism. About 90% of crack arrests are of African-Americans, while 75% of powder cocaine arrests are whites. Under federal law, it takes only 5 grams of crack cocaine to trigger a 5-year mandatory minimum sentence, but it takes 500 grams of powder cocaine, 100 times as much, to trigger the same sentence for a white boy.
Over 20 years in doing this, man, I'm just more careful about what I'm saying now. You ain't got my back, dude. I know who got my back and who don't have my, who have my back. Believe that. What up, B? Philly in the building, what up? I got my Philly fam in the building. Germany, what up? That's Wise Intelligence from Poor Righteous Teachers. Wise Intelligence, Poor Righteous Teachers, called Globe Holder. So I've been playing this on the radio, again, over 20 years in this, man. Over 20 years on radio, not blog talk, YouTube, Instagram, radio. So I know how people can get confused about, you know, because even Black Dot, my brother Zai said, Black Dot had a conversation on this too, about how we don't even know what to believe. So the best thing to do, people, is to support the people that can leave and talk to people outside of here. I'm not going to, you know, like I shared with Umi. Umi said, Sabir, you ain't got nothing to prove to these people on these feeds, man, because what happens, they're going to stop your movements and your freedom because niggas like to try to bait. And they love sitting back, oh, I saw that on such and such show because it said such and such and such. When I am the journalist that's been in every state, I've been a journalist over 20 goddamn years with this. I don't take what people say and run with it. It's real talk, real convo. So if you have not, if you cannot present the receipts, I don't want to hear nothing from you, B, because my feeds is open for anybody. What up, RC? My receipt is open for anybody if you want to bring some receipts. If I took the shot, I will let you know I took the shot. Nigga, if I was gay in this day and time, I'll let you know I was gay. Did that make sense, sister? I mean, I'm just trying to figure out. You ain't got to hide that you gay no more. Because if I was gay, I would let you know. And if I took the shot now, I would let you know I took the shot. Because that's the end thing now. That's the end thing. Okay? So I did tell you I took the test, but I came up negative. But I just told you because I know my health. I know my health. You follow me? So I'm fine. Don't try to bait me for nothing free on here either, because I'm going to embarrass the hell out of you if you try to play me. Okay? So I'm going to show y'all how misinformation goes out before we start, if y'all don't mind. Did y'all see that post up? And I know most of y'all saw the post, right? Do you see the post that was talking about these people, the so-called Taliban was partying? Did y'all see that? And they said they took over and they was listening to Drake. Did y'all hear that?
No.
I saw that meme.
I didn't see that.
Mm-hmm. You didn't see it? Niggas are niggas put up. Niggas are sharing it out.
I didn't see it.
Oh, you didn't see it? Let me see if I can find it for you. Bear with me. Let me see if I can find it. So what happened? Somebody, give me 1 second. Damn, where's the joint at? Give me 1 second. Mute your mic, brother, because I hear everything in the background. So please mute your mic until you want to talk. So bear with me 1 second. So there was a video floating around and niggas jumped on it like a hoe in heat. It don't mean as a the female's a hoe, because a guy could be a hoe too. So this is the video. I can't make this up. This is the video. This is how misinformation floats. Give me 1 second. I can't make this up. I'm not lying. It's not. This is serious. It said Taliban soldiers jam into Drake after taking local club. This is how. This is 4 days ago. Listen to me. I can't make this up. This is how people put fake stuff on social media 4 days ago. But guess who that is? Do you see that? 4 days ago. Go down. Always pay attention to the dates, right? 4 days ago. But guess what? That wasn't them. Hold up. I'm going to rock with y'all for 1 second. Bear with me. Bear with me. I'm going to show y'all how people that don't do research on anything. Shout out to my sister for also sharing this with me. So she said, that is not the Taliban. I'm going to ask y'all, have you ever heard of these people? And y'all can Google these people. I'm going to ask y'all this question. Have you ever heard of these people called the Pushtun? Have you ever heard of them?
Mm-mm. No, I never heard of them.
I can't make this up. Yo, this is funny. I'm going to post it up so y'all can look it up online. I swear, I can't make this up, yo. Go look these people up right there. P-A-S-H-T-U-N. Now, a person that don't do research, right? Oh, RC, no. Listen, this is a ceremonial wedding dance, right? This is them right here. A game no more is in Pakistan, Pushtun Village. But this is who that they just told you took over the goddamn club. Niggas, like they be on the ground. Hold on, let me zoom in on this, man. They be talking like they be on the ground with this information. Yo, bro, I can tell you what's going on, bro. Yeah, man, that was the Taliban, brother. Yo, yeah, I can't make this up. Our people are crazy, yo. Now, everybody going to post that up there. Thank y'all. But please give me the credit and my sister the credit, because I'm going to keep it real with you. I'm a real journalist, brother. I don't take what nobody says and run with this. It's a game. Look them up. It's a game. This is why people don't know who to believe. Ask these dudes who are talking to cite their sources. Cite their sources. Either you was there reporting on the ground, because you got some of these Europeans, right? Yes, but it was a ceremony. I just gave the tribe, right? So what I'm saying to you, either you on the ground, because you ever see these places that go to war, like, and you got people that's there reporting this? How about we back yeah. people like that, that will be there, that I'm willing to do it. If I got fine, if I got 50 grand to do all this, B, I'll be on the ground like a mug, B. If I got 50 grand to do this and then report this back to y'all, I'd be cool. Let's see if I can get the support, because I'm going to go overseas. Let's see if I can get the support there. Right? Everything I show you receipts on. I'm not making this up. But let me tell you what we love. We love sensationalism. We love people that can't back up what they're saying, but unless they got it off of YouTube and Facebook. But we're the same. Where is the source that shows that is? I just showed you. Now it's up to you to go research that motherfucker. I just gave it to you. I'm not your encyclopedia, B. If you want to hire me, hire me. Pay me to go do that. How about that part? You can pay me to do that. You can hit me up. My Cash App work. It works very well. So what happens when you start researching all of this, you'll start understanding what's going on. Let me share something else with y'all. Because the reason why I'm doing this, because I'm going to walk y'all into what this brother said about we're not, Africans are not the original Jews. But I want that brother to get some time to get on the feed, because I'm going to expose him. Sabir Bey, number one live stream. Give thanks, family. I appreciate that. They may hurt their feelings too by you saying that. But there was a post a sister sent me too, right? And I have to be careful again, y'all, because you know how they are. That nigga Sabir is on here telling y'all what's going on. This was July 30th, 2021. COVID-19 fully vaccinated woman dies in Galveston County. 33 years old. Now, Jesse is in the hospital right now with his wife. They got the shot. She took the shot too, this girl. But why the news is not telling y'all this? I'm being real with y'all. Why would I take something and know I'm going to, I don't know about that, but anywho, I wouldn't do it. But anywho, I got to be careful, y'all. So this is her. You can research this on ABC 13. ABC. Now, remember when I told you about what happened in Texas? How they the worst eaters, like a mother freaking. You know Texas got a lot of meat there, B? Like, you know that lot of pork there? Niggas be tearing that mother. Yeah, hold up. You know, you ever hear that saying? I want all my good Christians and all my good people who's worried about the COVID. Remember, y'all used to say, you got to die from something. You ever hear that saying before?
Everybody says that.
Yeah, I ain't never seen nothing like that. I would never say
that. Don't talk about the people that did it. They all said
it. I was raised on pork. You got to die from something. When death knock on your door, then you want to start crying. When death start knocking on that door, boom, boom, boom. Nigga, please God, give me one more chance. Biggie, give me one more chance. Some nigga be speaking Biggie song. Come on, God, give me one more chance. Give me one more chance. And then God gave you the chance. You ignored that mother freaking. You ignored it. Because the God that you serve is not the supreme being. The God that you serve is the damn government. It's the media. Are y'all following me? There it is, right there. 33 years old. Damn, she was young. Look.
Yeah, that's young.
Look, I gotta do this for y'all. Hold up. I gotta do this tomorrow. 33 years old. Hold up. I gotta do this, babe. Hold up. I gotta pray for her. Right?
But let's don't have worry a moment of silence.
You gotta die from something. Don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry. Just be happy. You ain't got to worry about it. Think about this, man. This is insane. So I want y'all to hear how they trick you. This is a movie, and I'm going to tell everybody to go. You want to see the pic? You must want my video to be taken down, huh? Here it is right there. ABC News. That's it right there. See, this is what journalism is supposed to do. Journalists supposed to show you this, right? They're supposed to tell you this, right? But what, they gonna blame it on the alcohol? Then again, he probably can. But anyway, blame it on alcohol. Could it be that? So they're gonna blame it on the unvaccinated people when they put the vaccine in your body. They put the shit in you. 33 years old, don't believe me. You can't block this, man. It's the news. Y'all don't get the propaganda yet. You don't get the damn propaganda yet. You don't get this yet. It's here. It's been here. But if I can pay off certain people, we okay. Do you? There's a movie, right? Y'all should go watch it on Netflix. It's called Sweet Girl. Did you see that movie yet tomorrow? Listen to me. I don't really advocate movies like this, but this movie is called Sweet Girl. And in the movie, go on Netflix. It was that boy, the dude is married to Lisa Bonet. To Lisa Bonet, right? The big dude. He played Aquaman. Okay, watch that movie. I swear to God. Watch that movie. You're going to do a video on it. In this movie, I swear you're going to do a movie on this mother freaking. Listen, as I'm watching this movie, at the end, it's a spin at the end of this movie. And at the end of the movie, I'm not going to tell, but you know how a child grow up and a child went through some trauma, like you bombing a country or something like that. And a child grows up and a child has some type of animosity, or like we did with the Europeans. We put them up in the Caucasus Mountains and then we left them up in the Caucasus Mountains. And when we let them niggas go, they came back and said, we're going to do damage to these niggas, because we enslaved Europeans first. We did that. So when you leave your child alone, your child comes back, or something happened as a child because they can't do too much as a child. But when they get older, they remember. That's why they have to get children while they're young to tame this mental. Get them in kindergarten, kind of a garden. That's really what kindergarten is, a kind of a garden. So they get them while they're young, right? So I'm just going to tell you how this was in this movie. As I'm watching this movie, it started hitting me about my mom, right? So it was a pharmaceutical, a senator, like all these niggas right now, these black people, that's never telling you about health. They're only telling you to get the jab. While all the white people are telling you to go take care of your health. I'm going to play two videos before we get into this. Every Negro, like I played that lady from the news, telling you go get a shot, but they never tell you to go eat right. So in this movie, all this is happening. My mom died from pancreatic cancer and secondhand smoke cancer, right? Do anybody tell your mate to stop smoking cigarettes? How many of y'all sit around people that smoke cigarettes? I love him so much. Girl, I don't care, I'm used to the smoke now. But secondhand smoke is worse than goddamn smoking itself. And most of y'all sit around people who smoke, right? So all this is happening, right? As in the movie, and I had to sit back and think about this. Where does the hell word cancer come from? So cancer just dropped out of the sky somewhere? Like, did they have cancer in ancient times? Or was it called cancer? And what is the word cancer anyway? I think it's a German word. Okay, so as I'm watching this movie, bruh, seriously, y'all, I'm watching it. And it was something to heal people from cancer. And the lady was on her deathbed. The reason why I'm saying this is because I was with my mother and my father when they both died, both of them. My mom, I was with her when she took her last breath. I found my father. He had colon cancer and lung cancer, both of them, right? And when I was in a hospital I was with my older brother, older sister. I am the only one. I'm the middle child out of nine. I'm the only one that's asking the doctors questions. My sister works in the same hospital. Y'all be swearing these doctors know something. They don't know shit. I asked the doctor, how do you get cancer? You know what he said to me? I told y'all this story before. He said, bad luck. I want to fight this motherfucker. My brother was tripping because my brother's one of those pro Christian guys. He come home from jail. He's a Christian guy and don't even know Christianity. But anyway, I'm in there wanting to fight this motherfucker. And I'm telling the doctor, and my mom been going for 11, 12 years, I think. My father been going for 15, I think. So anyway, I'm in the hospital and I'm arguing with the doctor, my brother, and my sister. And I'm sitting here and I'm like, no, it comes from the dye or the plastic that hardens the arteries up. You don't supposed to eat deep fried food. Canola oil, corn oil, that's not good for our people. But what's good for us is olive oil. Olive oil, pure olive is grown in Tunis. Ask somebody about the best olive oil. If you get olive oil, go get some Tunisian olive oil. I swear to God, go. Go Google Tunisian olive oil. Can't make this up. It's from the olive. And then do the research on Tunisian olive oil, right? Why? Because it lubricates the system. Olive oil lubricates it. If you want to take it, go take it at nighttime before you go to sleep. Drink some and drink some orange juice and watch how you feel. It's going to flush you. So I'm sitting in a hospital. I remember like it was yesterday. I was telling this story today to my peoples out here in Chicago as we was eating. And I'm sitting here and I said, I need to talk about this. I need to talk about it. So when the doctor told my sister that, I wanted to fight the doctor literally in the hospital. That's how crazy it was. But what we do, and I said this, what we do is kill our children. We kill the animals. We feed the animals the red 40, the yellow 40. Read your ingredients on your Doritos, Negroes, and your Cheetos. Read the ingredients, what it says. We are doing it. We're giving the animals cancer. So all of this is happening as I'm watching this movie and the big businesses and how the father, Jason, I think his name was, in the movie, right? He was trying to find out and was a whistleblower in the motherfucker, but it was $1 billion. It was a lot of money behind to keep this secret. But the senator was playing both parts. Are y'all following me? It's the same thing. The senators was playing both parts. Yo, and the lady said, I took the bribe. This is what's going on with most of your people that's on radio and television. This is what's going on with a lot of these people. I took the money. Go watch the movie, Sweet Girl. Go watch it. The whole process, and it was like, there is a cure for cancer. What kills our people is the chemo. It's not for us, people. It's not for us. I had to tell my father, and it was crazy to sit here and tell my father that it was what you were doing to your life. When you sit back and really, most of y'all probably dissected animals. I never dissected an animal in school. Who dissected a frog in school? And why would they dissect a frog in school? Why would they dissect frogs in school? Because of what? The anatomy of the body is the same goddamn thing. Do you know when I was in Grenada, in order for them to figure out is the water drinkable, you know what they were doing? They were dropping frogs in the water in Grenada. And then the next day, if they're alive, the water was drinkable. Who the hell you think they got the pH things from? Your ancestors, because you don't know who you are. They were the Moors. This is a fact when I was in Grenada. And I'm getting the history, which I didn't never know. They would leave them there, and if they come back tomorrow, if they're dead, that's not drinking water. Obviously, you don't eat iceberg lettuce. It's acid. But how many people don't even pay attention to the iceberg? You just, nigga, this is good, nigga. I'm coming from the club. We eating it. So we're causing our problems and trying to sit up and say, well, brother, you got to get the shot. You got to get a shot, but they're not telling you what the shot do to you. The iceberg lettuce, I'm literally, brother, at my father's footsteps. Like literally, as he was dying, before he died, my father said it was felt like something scratching his insides. My father smoked since he was 14, Pall Mall cigarettes. Nigga, I said Pall Mall. My father died at 73. So think about the whole years of him smoking, eating liver, eating pork, eating ice cream, which causes heart disease. Just imagine over the years. So I'm sitting at my father, and every time I saw him, he was on his way out anyway. He kept looking like this, and he would lay back down. And he would look up again, and he would lay back down. I found him in the morning with his eyes open. I had to close his eyes. He couldn't even close because the rigor mortis had set, and he had to die early in the morning. I had to close his eyes. So if I feel all of this, so the things that I'm speaking about from my son's death down to my mom, down to my father. I'm telling you this, but they don't want to have this conversation. I'm looking, and I told my father this. I told my father. He said it was felt like something was eating his insides. And this is what I told my father. I was probably bad that night, man. I'm going to be real with you. But I knew he was going to go, but not that next day. But I said, Dad, your body is looking for nutrients. That's what I told him. He said, give me one more chance. I said, Dad, I swear. I said, Dad, he gave you the chances, G. He gave them to you. We don't pay attention. They gave it to you. It sits there. It's right in front of your face. But the white man or whoever you want to call him, you don't want to ignore. You, man, he said it right here because he got that white coat on. He's smart. He got Doctor in Blue on his jacket. They couldn't do anything, so they sent them home. And my mom is the same thing. And that's why my mom didn't want to come home, because my father died home. And my mother died home. My point is that when I'm sitting with him, I told him his insides were looking for nutrients. When you look, I had iguanas. All my iguanas died because I was giving them the wrong lettuce. Every iguana died within a week span. A week. And I asked the dude, what is killing my iguanas? Are you selling me a bad batch? He said, what are you feeding them? Just like the doctor asked you, what did you eat before you got here? Or what is your problem? Only you know the anatomy of your body. You do, but you damn, you're hard-headed. You're hard-headed. Only you know your body. I didn't go to school and dissect frogs, nigga, and say I went to Harvard and Spelman and Yale. I never went to those schools, but I always knew the anatomy of my body. I knew how my body healed. I knew how my body reject things. For instance, this is the craziest thing. I just found out I can't even take goddamn copper. This is how crazy. You know your body will react a certain way. Take some copper without eating. Watch what your body feel like. You be like, nigga, you going to vomit. But copper is one of the minerals that you need. So is zinc. Copper and zinc is what you need. Oh, don't worry about it. Oh, thank you, brother. Sorry for your loss. I'm fine, brother. I understand life and death. Sorry for your loss. I'm fine. I never lost anything. I gained. See, this is the difference. I didn't lose anything. I've gained. I gained the ancestor of my son. I gained the ancestor of my father. I gained the ancestor of my mother. They all live in me. I don't buy into that. You know, oh, brother, no, B. I gained them. They're with me. This shall soon pass. This will soon pass. And I tell people, you sit here and talk about dying, or you got to die from something. The nigga died. You know, when I got shot those 5 times, I wanted to die. But the dude told me, I can't let you go, bro. I can't let you go. I was ready to leave, but I have a mission. I have a mission to accomplish. And when that mission is done, you all will know. I don't fear death. It's going to come to all, B. I had bullets all in me. I was ready to roll. So everybody's mission is different. So don't come to me telling me that you got to die from something and you scared of this. Tell me, oh, brother, the COVID is real. The Delta is worse than the goddamn COVID. Nigga, AIDS is too, nigga. I used to be scared of somebody that had AIDS when I was younger. Seriously, I thought it made you gay. Excuse me. Don't get offended. But I did. But I'm being honest.
They got a vaccination for that now. Did you?
Yeah, they got a vaccination. But the habit. Listen to the habit. Do that stop you from doing that? That's a habit. We have habits, man. The habits is what's getting you caught up. Your bad habits. You follow me? It's like somebody may say, well, I'm going to eat all bullshit, and I'm going to just detox, and I'm going to eat the bullshit tomorrow. Nigga, like, what the heck? Whoa, wait a minute. How? That don't make sense to you. That's insane. That's craziness, man. We are eating a European diet. That is not us. And I'm sitting here like, well, back in the day, cancer wasn't here. It wasn't. But if I tell you white sugar, cancer thrives off of white sugar. You say, no, but the doctor didn't tell me that. Yeah, all right. It's about money, B. And that's what that whole movie was about. Sweet girl. Sweet girl. And she had to make the senator that y'all worship so damn much. The senator said it to her. I took the money. I took the bribe. You can't bribe Sabir. It's not happening. And they know this. And this is why they don't know about me. Everybody says, I don't know who Sabir Bey is. Yeah, yes, you do. You just can't bribe me. Do he like little girls? He like little boys? He like guys? Which one he want? He want the money? Nigga, I'm not impressed because I had cars. I had women all my life. I didn't have money. I'm fine. You can't bribe me on that, B. Bribe me on the truth. Let's have a slogan. You know how they say I've been vaccinated? Y'all should start making things. Did you read a book lately? You ever see those rings? You ever see those rings? Yeah. Got my vaccine shot. How about doing a ring and say, did you read a book lately? Matter of fact, we got to be right with this. Seriously. Did you read True History? I'm just throwing some out there tomorrow. Anybody want to make that little ring? You know what I mean? Did you read a real history? Did you read a J.A. Rogers book? Did you read any? Let's do something like that and see how many people will share them motherfuckers out. Just like they gave Jesse Jackson a sticker. You see that when Jesse got the shot? And they put the sticker on Jesse. That's crazy. They gave Jesse Jackson a shot and put like he was a kid, my nigga. Did y'all see that? Did y'all see what he did? Like he gave him the shot and put a sticker like here now, be a good boy. That was crazy. That's a grown ass. Yo. That was crazy, dude. Like, go watch this when Jesse got the shot. I said, yo, that's like when you go get a needle in the hospital when you was a child. You know, you get a lollipop or something like that. Like, in a sticker. You know what I mean? That's what they did to Jesse Jackson. This can't be real. They just give him a sticker. I had to rewind that motherfucker back. That was crazy. I'm watching this and like, are y'all paying attention to really what's going on? You really listening to these politicians? Cashews and almond milks are too. Man. Swiss chard, kale, spirulina is rich. Yeah, copper. Yeah, thank you. But they're not telling our people none of that. Let me tell you what they're telling y'all. Bear with me. That's why we can't even recognize that we the original Jews. But you're a Christian though, right? Niggas want to argue with you, babe. They probably be the main one eating a hot dog. You remember hearing that? You ever see Bad Boys and Martin was sitting at the table and he was talking about the bologna? And which mm-hmm. Kong said, my baloney got a first name. He said, no, your baloney got a million names. Remember that part? He was sitting there in the first Bad Boys, and he took the baloney and he put it in the water and ate that motherfucking subliminals. Yeah. Go watch Bad Boys when he was sitting there. He said, yeah, your baloney got a lot of names. And what happens, hot dogs have a lot of stuff in that motherfucking. It's the scraps. And nigga be like, yo, these Franks taste good, but the Franks been killing niggas since 732. But you eating Frank hot dogs. We don't know nothing about Charles Martel, the French dude, but we eating French hot dogs. Franks. Ain't this what they call it? Franks, right?
Franks. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I thought so. But they got a lot of stuff inside that motherfucker. You worrying about your health. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. COVID is real. If I just went over your head, I'll bring you right back because it makes sense, right? And some of y'all guilty like a mug. Guilty. What are you supposed to do, Sabir? I'm telling you what to do. I'm not your doctor. I'm not your leader. I'm not a politician, but these motherfuckers are all in the bed together. And when you watch that movie, believe me, when you watch that movie, right? Sweet Kid, Sweet, whatever, I forgot the name of it, right?
You want to see
Sweet Girl, you want to see it. You want to see what they were going through in the hospital, how they play this game. You're going to see it. Straight up. You're going to be like, yo, it makes so much sense. And you're fighting to try to get people to understand what's going on while these people get billions of dollars. Even some of these cats on social media get $1 billion to actually mislead you. This is crazy. So I'm going to show you the Negroes that get paid off. Listen to this guy, and I'm going to play this European dude. Listen to it. And if y'all know this guy named Representative Richie Torres, I don't know him, but I would have a one-on-one with this clown. He looked like he looked kind of like he got sugar in his tank anyway, but I don't know. Too much sugar. Oh, you being judgmental? I can do that. That's my prerogative. But I'm just saying, I'm trying to piss him off so he can come on.
I can't.
No, but the name is Richie. Vaccine mandates for air travel. This nigga put a legislation in, not even understand that black folks don't even have power. If they do anything, his name is Representative. What state is that? What state is that guy Richie Torres in? Have y'all noticed It's all so-called black people telling y'all to get the vaccine, and they're the worst goddamn eaters. Have y'all noticed that? Just think about it. Maybe I'm wrong. I was in a Whole Foods one day. I swear, I'm looking at all these little kids, white kids. I'm using white. These little girls, like 5 and 6, she's reading ingredients. No lie. She, the little girl like this. Dad, this has such and such. I said, what the? I had to pull back. The little girl was reading the ingredients. I was like she was in an ice cream aisle. I swear. And she's reading the ice cream ingredients to her father. You know what that made me think of? Daddy daycare. Breaking down the monodextrides, breaking that down. Made me think of that, right? But we don't teach our children that. See, my daughter's gonna be like that. My daughter gonna be like her dad. Like, we're gonna ask, well, dad, what's up? What's up with this? And this is the crazy part with our people. Even if you say that, this is what they'll say. Well, how you know what's in it? I said, nigga, I'm done. You can't win with our people. I swear to God, you can't win with our people. They'll say, how do you know it's in it? It's called research. How about that part? I can tell you what this does for you. I can tell you what hydrogenated oil does. It's, look it up. Look up hydrogenated oil. I told people to go look it up. And then pay attention to the margarine. I told you how to do a test. Take some margarine, because they tell you it's not parquet. What they say is parquet is not butter. They told you that. You see how they tell you the truth? They say it's not butter, it's parquet. That's what they'll tell you. But take some margarine, do it tomorrow, right? And sit it on a hot, if it's a hot day, sit it outside and tell me when you come back if it's plastic or not. And then think about that same plastic over a period of time in your arteries. Think about it. Y'all should do that with your children. I'm gonna be real with you. If you have a child, make that a science project. Didn't we used to have science projects in school?
Yep, we did.
We used to have science projects, right? So y'all should make that a science project. Straight up, a science project. Get a stick of margarine. You can get, if y'all cheap, go to the dollar store. I'm just joking. I don't even know if the dollar store sells butter. Do they even sell that stuff?
Butter?
No, no.
Oh, I don't even know if they do, but you can probably find it because it's cheap. Some stores, it's cheaper right here. Don't worry about it. But that's what we do. But take a stick of margarine, and people loads up. Have you ever saw people make yams? I saw somebody, this lady put literally pounds of sugar on yams, my nigga, like white sugar, which is a drug. I said, and you would be like, this is good. Think about it. And you worried about, that's why the governor said that African Americans actually is the cause of COVID, God damn it. Wow, my boy Ray RC said, now that's a science project. I'm gonna repeat that one more time for y'all. See, some people ain't gonna do it because you know why? They gonna be like, no, that nigga might be
right. I don't wanna stop.
No, they I don't wanna, see the bad habit again? You see how the bad habit comes again? I don't wanna touch that because I love my butter and my greens. I love my 1200 grams of sodium that I buy from the sandwich in Starbucks. I was in Starbucks, it was 12, I can't make this up, y'all. I cannot make this up. It was 12 grams of sodium inside of a sandwich. And I'm going right back to him. I'm setting this, y'all. Don't worry. I put that title up there for a reason because I don't want nobody to block my channel. But let me show y'all something. And I'm going to still get into it. So this is 930 grams of sodium. Right? Cholesterol 65. Right? Bear with me 1 second. I can't make this up. Most of y'all go right in Starbucks, don't even read it. They said that sandwich look gooder than a motherfucker right there, even though it's tuna fish. I don't know. Yeah, I don't eat this garbage. Right? This one has 1,200 grams of sodium, 80 milligrams of cholesterol. Where are these people in the center? That dude, this is a regular joint in Starbucks, right? That was yesterday when I took that picture, right? Give me 1 second. I'm gonna show y'all this. I don't know if y'all know what sodium does to you. I told y'all what happened when I was in Carthage. I got the history about them getting salt on the ground to kill the soil. They use salt when I was there. They said, when the Romans came in, remember I told you, all this stuff they got from history, they put salt on the soil to kill the ground, to kill the food. So this is 1,210 grams of sodium. That's a lot of goddamn sodium. Why do you think got migraine headaches? Hold up. This one has 930. And you got doctors going into this motherfucker. I sat there and I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna sit there one day and look at all the doctors that coming in and I'm gonna just start snapping pictures or I might go live. But you trust the doctor. Y'all trust the doctor because they wear a white coat. I'm gonna wear a police uniform and set y'all up. I'm a police officer. I'm playing dress up. I'm a politician. Now here you go. Here's the politician right here. Can't make this up. Doctors recommend that you eat at least 2,000 what milligrams of sodium per day. Wow. Listen.
To movie theaters, one local congressman is upping the ante and
really reconsider COVID restrictions.
Yeah, starting on September 13th, vaccinations will be required at restaurants, gyms, movie theaters. One local congressman.
Did you hear that? Let me break this down. Did y'all hear what they said? Because niggas like entertainment. I'm out here in Chicago. I just told y'all I went to the Cubs joint. I asked the lady a question. I said, what do you need to get in there? Right? So I asked the lady, what you need to get? I said, you need a shot? She said, no. I said, you need to wear a mask? She said, no. I said, you need to get a test? She said, no. I said, what do you need? She said, just to buy a ticket. Did you see my Instagram and Facebook when I was down there? Mm-hmm. I asked a question.
Yeah.
That was crazy. But yet, if you're not on the ground, you don't know that. Right? So when I watched this, I said, hold up. Who likes to go to restaurants? We said restaurants. What is it? Restaurants. Movie theaters, right? In concert. Mm-hmm. Niggas love
in
to
bars.
Be in bars, right? So all of those people are going in there killing their damn self. So you should need a vaccination. How about that part? You're going in those places because you know why you should. How about sitting home and have a home cooked meal? You know, my mom used to, you know, it was all of us. We all had to sit at the table, right? A home cooked real meal. Like, I miss my boy in France too, Blunty. It's a brother named Blunty, my sister Tiffany out in France, right? I ain't gonna lie. I felt like one of their kids. I'm gonna be real with you. Did you see my video when I was in France? They live in Toulouse, right? They gave me the upstairs. Like I had the upstairs apartment for myself and he was downstairs. So I would keep going downstairs and saying, yo, brother's dinner ready. Like I feel like a kid. Like I swear to God, he's from the Caribbean, right? Mm-hmm. So he would make food from scratch, straight up. She would make ginger from scratch, like that real ginger juice. Like, you know, my brain is colonized. I'm colonized, right? So I want iced tea. You know what I mean? Like, yo, you go to the store, get the iced tea. You know what I mean? But she would make real juice, like real ginger, right? Blunty would go out in the garden and make real food. So the food was so damn good. I felt like one of his kids. Oh, nigga, you want to adopt me, nigga? Like, what's up? That's how good food was, right? I'm serious, yo. So why don't we get back to that? What people are doing is they taking their children and you taking your girl out trying to impress her, nigga, with their lobster, with their shrimp, what up? You know what I mean? Yo, with their steak. You're killing her just for a piece of ass. That's crazy. I'll take out and buy a book for her. Be like, let's go to the bookstore.
Pick a book.
Right.
Y'all know half of people can't even boil water. So
it's true, but I'm just saying though, you know how many books I bought for females? I'm gonna keep it real. I bought books for females a lot. Like, I'll be like, yo, babe, yeah, you know what I mean? That's what you give them. That's it. But if you pay attention to what he said, if you pay attention, that's what they're focusing on because they want you to get out again, but you got to get vaccinated. Let me go on a little further. I want y'all to rock with me for 1 second.
That is upping the ante and asking the feds to implement a vaccine mandate for air travel. That is Congressman Richie Torres.
That would never happen.
This morning with details right on his. And good morning, Congressman. So good to see you.
Morning.
It's a pleasure to be here.
you know, the vaccine incentives have been working. We've seen an increase in the number of people going to get their COVID shots. How there's one local congressman
that never told you people dying
and asking the feds to implement a vaccine mandate for air travel. That is Congressman Richie Torres, and he joins us this morning with details on his plan. Good morning, Congressman. So good to see you.
Morning.
It's a pleasure to be here.
You know, the vaccine incentives have been working. We've seen an increase in the number of people going to get the COVID shots. However,
incentives are working.
Yeah, she said it.
Mm-hmm. What the hell is an incentive, y'all? Help me out. I mean, can we get some attorneys on this mug? What the hell is an incentive?
A payoff.
What did I just tell you about that damn movie? What did I just tell y'all what was going on? I know, but I ain't worrying about nobody. But that's what y'all, I know some of y'all might be scared, but I just want y'all to think about it for a second. She said, the incentives are paying off. Nigga, you ain't got to pay nobody off if this stuff works and real. Like, but they get a nigga like him. Let's go.
And it is the right way to go when it comes to air travel. Explain how that would work.
Yeah, so as the vice chair of Homeland Security, I'm introducing legislation that would mandate vaccination as a requirement for air travel. So the Transportation Security Administration prevents people from entering airplanes and airports with weapons. And there's a sense in which the Delta variant is a weapon. It's a biological weapon.
Did the nigga say,
wow.
Security, I'm introducing legislation that would mandate vaccination as a requirement for air travel. So the Transportation Security Administration prevents people from entering airplanes and airports with weapons. And there's a sense in which the Delta variant is a weapon. It's a biological weapon.
Viruses, hold up. So you mean the flu could be a weapon? Ignorance is a weapon. Nigga, do y'all understand? Listen, I just want y'all to pay attention. They should mandate a freaking ignorance being a damn weapon too. But we're gonna get into this in 1 second.
I would argue that there's no greater threat to the homeland security of the United States than the Delta variant, which is the most dangerous and deadliest form of the coronavirus.
Bro, I can't make this up.
Oh my gosh.
The swipe that I just got came from China. This is what I took the test in. It says made in China. How the hell could this swipe that I took the other Friday be made in China, but why isn't this a damn weapon? Let's go. Bear with me.
Coronavirus, and we have to strengthen the incentive to get vaccinated. We have to exhaust every means of crushing the virus.
So let me ask you this then. Would the vaccine requirement be for domestic travel? Would it be for just international flights? How are you actually seeing this play out?
So the mandate would apply to both.
So somebody hit this dude up, because I would like to smash him. Please share this to him. I'm so freaking serious. Share this to this dude. This nigga.
Hey, so let me ask you this, because the Biden administration's working on a plan now to require foreign visitors to be fully vaccinated. So you're saying that wasn't enough. That's why you and Mark Levin, you want to take this one step further and say everybody, no matter where you're going, has to be vaccinated.
We have to go much farther. And let me be clear, I'm not proposing a universal mandate. What I'm proposing are targeted mandates for certain circumstances and select settings.
What does that mean?
Such as air travel and large gatherings. You know, the Kaiser Family Foundation did a survey and found,
did he say Kaiser?
That there are four factors that can move the vaccine hesitant toward vaccination. The first is FDA approval, which hopefully will happen within the month. The second is a prescription from one's doctor, which would follow from FDA approval. The third is proof of vaccination in large gatherings. And the fourth was proof of vaccination for air travel. And that's the subject of my legislation.
So what about families who have children under the age of 12 who cannot get vaccinated? Does it mean that they can't travel?
The children would be exempt because the children are ineligible for vaccination. So there are exemptions for those.
That don't even make no sense.
Somebody get me a politician on this motherfucker, because goddamn, that didn't just make sense. You mean to tell me, nigga, somebody should ask him. I'd be like, well, do you mean the service dogs got to get vaccinated too? Because service dogs be on the damn plane too? I'm trying to figure it out, because I want to know if the service dogs can get vaccinated too. Yo, y'all don't realize what the hell is going on, B. This is crazy. And it's all black people who are saying these things. All of these Negroes who are saying these things.
It is.
Not one time you heard this man or any of these black people tell you to put the damn beef down, the hot dog down, the pork down, don't eat this, nigga, we are in trouble. We in trouble. You can come at me any kind of way you want, nigga. I'm not these weak ass niggas that's on YouTube and Facebook, because I don't, you can say I'm practicing medicine without a license, nigga. My ancestors are Moors. My ancient ancestors taught every last one of these people. Every last one of these people. And I study Ibn Sina. Did each and every last one of you doctors study? Let me say this. I studied Ibn Sina that you call Avicenna. You call Avicenna. Every doctor studies Ibn Sina, which is Avicenna, which is his Latin name. If I'm wrong, make me out of a liar. Get me on a doc. Get me a doctor on here. They are totally in violation of people's human rights. Why these niggas talking about, I'm a Democrat from such a nigga. What? You crazy. And y'all go for this, man. Oh, he sounds like he's smart. No, let me help y'all out. Bear with me. Now let's go to a European that's talking about your health. Let's go to him. Let's see what he talks about. His name is...
Your health is whose responsibility? Your health. Whose responsibility is it? Is it the insurance companies? So many, 25,000 patients, hundreds of...
His name is Dr. Living Good. Hold up.
So many, 25,000 patients, hundreds of thousands of clinical visits. There's still a lot of people that make decisions just based off what their insurance company will or will not pay for. They don't care about your health. Their business. It's not their job to take care of you. Is it your doctor's job? All week long, hundreds, if not thousands of messages. How do I find a doctor like you, Dr. Living Good? How do I find someone? My doctor doesn't want to work with me. All they want to do is push pills. All they want to do is cover up the symptoms. All they're looking at is just doing testing. They're not helping me get to the cause of it. They're not helping me change my lifestyle. They're not helping me figure out what's going on here. They're just treating it and telling me to come back when there's a problem again. Is your doctor's job to get you healthy? Is your employer? Your employer's job with benefits, retirement plans, insurance plans. It's not their job. Their job is to get the most productivity out of you, keep you healthy enough so you can show up for work. It's not their job to keep you healthy. Whose job is it to keep you healthy? It's you. It's you. No one's coming for you. No one's coming for you. If you're facing diabetes right now, if you're facing a blood pressure that's too high or too low, if your cholesterol is off, your triglycerides aren't firing and there's way too many of them and not working properly, if you have headaches, if you have a digestive diagnosis, maybe you have reflux, maybe it's GERD, maybe there's an ulcerative colitis issue or a Crohn's disease, if you're numb, tingly, if you have sinus and allergy problems, I could just keep going on these symptoms. Whose job is it to figure out what the heck is going on there? You really think that Big Pharma is going to come up with another pill that's just going to eradicate the condition that you have? Well, that would put them out of business. They ain't coming up with that. And yet that's never happened. 40 years, 50 years of major big medical, big pharma companies. And we have no cures. We have remedies. We're not getting to the bottom of things. If you're scared about your immune system right now, it's not going to be a vaccination or something that's going to save and miraculously protect you or reverse some kind of condition. Whose job is it? It's yours. Doctors often won't talk to you this way. Big Pharma certainly ain't putting a commercial on TV or talking to you this way. Your insurance company just isn't in the business of doing this. But I feel like it's my job, doctor means teacher, to speak to you from a leadership perspective. Whose job is it to get you healthy? It's your own. No one's coming for you. There isn't going to be a miracle. And it's not to say that we have to just eradicate our medical system or a drug or a shot or whatever it is. I don't, whatever your beliefs are on that. What I'm for, what I'm speaking on is healthy human beings. And there is only, by law, the way God made it, one way to become a healthy human being. Build health. That's it. We do not need $2 billion more dollars of research to go into the next pharmaceutical concoction to keep.
I'm in the wrong field. I'm going to leave y'all alone. I'm a researcher. God damn. Can I get $2 billion? His name is
Can I get $2 billion, man? I'm a hell of a researcher, man. Damn, let's go.
Healthy. If you want to use that stuff, if you've taken care of yourself so poorly that you have to have a medication, my dad did it. I lived it. Let's not have that narrative. But I saw my father have to have some emergency medical care. But as soon as he was out of emergency, what was the focus? Building health. And what I found is you cannot find that in a hospital. It's not a place for health, sickness and disease. You cannot find that in a drug company. It's not a health company. It's a drug company. You cannot find that with an insurance company. It's there for when you get in a crisis and lose your health. What I found is you got to build health. So we had to get him the heck out of there. I wrote my dad's story down and I put it in this book. If you've never grabbed one, you can right now. It's Living Good Daily. And it's a number one bestseller on Amazon, but my wife and I bought thousands of them and we're just giving them away. You just cover the shipping, I'll send it anywhere in the United States. But what it shares, what I want you to understand about this book is the formula to build health. There's a formula to it. It's not overly complicated. It's the way God made it. But a lot of people have never seen the formula in this simplicity. And there are tens of thousands of people.
So his name is basically Dr. Live Good, right? Mm. So let me tell you how crazy we are in this conscious community. I saw a post, and I always talk about health. I saw a post with these brothers talking about build wealth, right? And niggas on social media talking about I made 65K. I don't know what this new thing they get out now. Do you know how stupid that is to brag about how much you made? Do you ever see KRS-One talking about how much he made, or do he talk about health, wealth, and knowledge of self? He talk about health, wealth, and knowledge of self, and he show it. Niggas are talking about, and y'all know who these groups are, and they may be watching this, and when I say it, y'all gonna catch it. They got this group running around talking about, I made 65K, I can bear witness. Nigga, what about the wealth, the health? Do you know when you make over $10,000, you bluntly out here telling people this, that niggas, they gonna, who's watching you? Really? You made how much? But they forgot to tell you that part. That when you make over $10,000 and you bragging about this motherfucker, they gonna be right on your doorstep. Did that make sense? Did I just drop something? Y'all? Did y'all pay attention to what I just said? Mm-hmm. Y'all know who these people are. It's a group that's out here. And they always protest, yeah, man, I'm very rich. I made 65K. Nigga, who does that? If you know a real hip hop head, they really don't tell you how much they make. I ain't talking about these fake dudes. You become a target, right? Yeah, a target. Not against us, against them. Because when you sit there, and I hope these brothers hear this, there's a bunch of them. I hope you brothers hear this. Right? I can tell you all about that, Ray. Whatever you're thinking, get out your head. I got that. I'm fine. I know all about that just because I don't talk about it. Trust me, I know what I'm saying. Trust me. So if you're doing these things, they're watching. And I can't tell you who told me. This is a real dope, reliable source too. My man is hip hop. He's real hip hop. You're real hip hop. So it doesn't matter. If you got 65K, nobody's walking around. Here's Ray, y'all. He's back on his hating again, but I don't care, but he can come on my feed. But if you have 65K, are you going to put it in your mattress? Thank you, brother. You're going to shake your head, right? You ain't going to put 65K in your mattress, are you? Okay. You ain't going to travel with 65K either, right? So let me help y'all out. Do you know what happened to Dr. Sabi when Dr. Sabi got jammed and what happened and nobody came to his rescue? He had money on him. He had a lot of money on him. A lot of money.
Definitely no.
Right? Okay, so I ain't going to save it too much because Ray is only trying to get me to say something. But if Ray want to be a man, he can come on my feed and be a man. Okay? So let's talk about our health. That's the real wealth. What I just posted up there is for anybody who has diabetes. The dude was just talking about diabetes. This is called Geneema. This is Geneema. You can do your research, and I did a video on this years ago on Geneema. I don't want you to believe in me. I want you to go look up Geneema
And then you do your own due diligence and figure it out. Do your due diligence on what I just showed you about Geneva, if you really want to fix your health. G-Y-M-N-E-Y-M-Y. That is the real health is the real wealth is your health. That is the real health. Wealth.
I bet a lot.
That is the real wealth. If you have somebody or know somebody that has it, so you got to hit it off. And what that does is that when you act, because I did it with my cousin in Philly. This is the craziest thing ever. We stopped because he loved Dunkin' Donuts, he loved white milk, whatever, right? We stopped at a Dunkin' Donuts in West Philadelphia. He bought 3 donuts and a big cup of coffee. And I said, you know, I'm watching him. And I gave him some, the powder. And he bit the donut and he spit the donut and the coffee out of his mouth because he didn't have no taste. Let me tell you how conditioned we truly are. He went. Give me 1 second. I'm going to show it to you. Give me 1 second. It's Geneva. I'm going to spell it to you one more time. Right? And if you go to YouTube and punch in Sabir Bey and Geneva, you'll actually see that video. You won't see me with no locks in my hair. We were in New York. Give me 1 second. I'm going to post that one more time. Geneva. G-Y-M-N-E-M-A. So what my cousin did, he bit the donut and he went home and I'm watching him go to the kitchen. He took a 5-pound bag of sugar and poured it in his coffee. When I tell you, he only had like a 16-ounce coffee. So think about this. 16-ounce coffee from the Dunkin' Donuts, right? And poured the sugar in there, like literally took the bag and poured. I said, nigga, he's killing himself, right? So what that does, it kills the taste for anything from ice cream to anything that has a high content of sugar in it. He was mad at me the whole day. That nigga was calling me mad as a mother freaker. Try it. Trust me. If you don't want your children to eat certain things, try it. Just sneak this to them and see what happens. That's why we can't get it together. That's why. It ain't because you're white, man. Because, again, I just told you the test I did. I ain't got to lie about anything I'm saying on here. That's all you got to do is show me your receipts on what I'm saying is wrong. The feed is open. And I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to be a buck with you. If you feel it like you and your feelings, I'm good with that too. You got 5 minutes to air me out. Don't come and tell me and go left field and right field. No, I won't cut you off either. I'm not going to cut you off. That's my promise. I won't. But please, if you sound stupid, then I'm going to ask you a question and don't get mad. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to get rid of you. Or don't never come on my feet again. If you don't like the way I'm telling it, that's your problem. That's not Sabir Bey's problem. The link is right there. Or go get me a doctor. And then we can have a talk. Okay? Go get me an attorney and then we can have a talk. We ain't got time to be playing. We don't have time to be playing. Seriously. At all with people. So what I'm going to do, people, is that I'm going to switch up the subject. Again, the lines is open for anybody that wants to come on. How long I've been on here? Hour and 24 minutes. I'm almost done. So share this out. Thank everybody and thank the people that was telling me this is the hottest YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram. I thank y'all. So share it. Sugar is in everything. Exactly. If you want to do anything, I'm going to help y'all out. Yo, this is so funny. If nothing changed, Ray, you should say bye. See, this is the thing I'm talking about. Ray is always saying, I don't see nothing to change. Well, why don't you leave, Ray? Why don't you leave? I told you I would make a clown out of you, B. And I don't care if you like it. You can come on my feet and curse me out. You know what Black Dot said? Black Dot said that Facebook, this internet made people tough guys. Because you know why? Because they nowhere near you. That's what he said. It made niggas. But if they was in the present, they wouldn't do nothing. That's what Black Dot said. It made niggas tough. They could be talking greasy online, nigga.
They do.
They be talking. That's a nigga be talking greasy, B. Damn. But if you want to do this,
Get some of this. He's not even paying attention. Everybody saying you a clown, Ray, but he's in the field right now. He in his bag. How do you say you in the bag? He in his bag right now. But anyway, get some monk. Get some of this. He going to cry in a minute. You ever see Friday?
You silly. That was my mama's chain.
That was my mama's chain.
No, you did not. You did not.
Get this right here. Oh, my feed is open, B. It's open, homie. So this is the monk. This is monk fruit. Shout out to my sister for putting me down with this. Okay, shout out to her for putting me down with this. This is monk sugar. And actually, it's really kind of good, y'all. Mm-hmm. It's really kind of good. Okay? So if you want your own channel, go to your own channel, do your own video. And thank you if you talk about me on your channel, because everybody's going to come to my channel. Thank you very much, people, for the free plug. So when you talk about me, everybody's going to come to my channel, and they could be real men and real women, and they could come on and say, well, Sabir, I saw this about you. So here it is. Thank you for the free plug. Appreciate you. I love when I get people to plug me for free. But I won't plug them for free. We're going to switch up in a minute, y'all. Brains are free. You got no time to joke and play. Because knowledge reigns supreme. While others play that game for fame. The concepts bring you stress and strain. But bless all those that know my name. It's knowledge reigns supreme. Do I call myself God when I'm speaking? People always ask me this question when I'm teaching. What you gotta understand is that crystal exists. The only existence is God consciousness. And God consciousness is what exists in Chris. Your ego tells you that you're doing all this. You a mister, a mister, professional lyricist. I get rid of this forever and only gets better. Chris from the universe, you can never sever. Cause there is no Chris, only the universe, remember. Going a little deeper, you can check me. My whole campaign is about living life correctly. But don't respect me, respect the universe. It's her verse that I disperse and free you from the curse of the Spaniards, the French, Portuguese, and English. Check me out, living life correctly. But don't respect me, respect the universe. It's her verse that I disperse and free you from the curse of the Spaniards, the French, Portuguese, and English. Check me as I sing this science of mine. I bring this. The word I bring to you today is knowledge reigns supreme. You got no time to joke and play, cause knowledge reigns supreme. While others play that game for fame, the concepts bring you stress and strain. But bless all those that know my name, it's knowledge reigns supreme. I bring you out the cave and change how you behave. Everything you see is really particles and waves. Not to mention, your visual extension is ruled by perception, guiding your every direction. If you really want money, your mentality must switch. If you really want to be rich, you gotta act like a bitch. You can't act like a bitch. If you want to be a lady, you can't get the gravy if you're sitting around lazy. You can't be in the hustle if you ain't looking for trouble. You can't be single if you know you really double. You can do it, yeah. We can do it, yeah. You can do it, yeah. We can do it, yeah. We the best. Don't worry about the card they dealt ya. It's real, I perceive myself out the shelter. Every day and night, seeing myself rock the mic. Lyrics tight, getting paid right for my mental sight. Rich and I'm poorer, expanding my aura to attract more of positive energy.
What you dealing with? What you telling me?
The word I bring to you today is knowledge reigns supreme. You got no time for joke and play, cause knowledge reigns supreme. While others play that game for fame, the concepts bring you stress and strain. But blessed are those that know my name, it's knowledge reigns supreme. Shout out to KRS-One. So, y'all do remember when I was in Leimert Park two Sundays, right? Y'all know I was mm-hmm. home, right? Okay, mm-hmm. this one. I forgot I was home when somebody said it was 20 minutes away. But anyway, my sister said, what's your point of watching him? Talking about Ray, right? She said, you got something valuable to say it. These cheap ass insults. Exactly. They insults. He's not paying attention to somebody who's talking to him. But he said, I'm talking smack and it's amazing. But Sabir was at Leimert Park for two Sundays straight and they were there. So I don't hide behind social media. When I'm home, I'm not going to make my way out unless it's a gig, G. If I'm getting paid, I would do that. The best thing to do if you come on my feed, if you don't have the information or something to share, shut the hell up and do your own video. I'm fine with it. I'm good. Oh, to come on the feed. I told you, you got 5 minutes. I'm fine. So we're going to move a little further. So we good. Thank everybody for joining me. So there was a post up. I told you I was going to switch up. There was a post that came on my Instagram. And the brother said that the Africans were not the original Jews. He said that there was no J's in the Hebrew language. That may be true, but how about the language of Ge'ez? Brother, I don't have to let you, nigga, get off my feed, Ray. Seriously, because people getting pissed off at me. He said, this is all you got to do is let you know an event. Nigga, get off my feed. Please. I ain't got to let you know nothing. You ain't paying me, brother. And I'm sorry, y'all, because this nigga's like a, he's like that gnat that keep flying around you, that you got to keep swishing away. Let him know in advance, nigga, pay me, then I'll meet you. Get the hell off the feed. God damn, man, what's wrong with these grown men? He's a grown ass man. Mm-hmm. You got something to say, come say it to Sabir Bey on here. Nigga, stop, man. Seriously, this is an embarrassment, man. And I'm gonna tell y'all, y'all be having some weak ass brothers, man. Y'all be having some weak ass men. He may have to go outside to go get on the phone to come on the live. Be real, man. Like, seriously, man. Like, stop.
I think he did that one day.
He did quite a few times, but damn, mommy, like, come on, B. We grown men here. If you got an issue with me, tell me what you got an issue with me about. Come on my feet. I don't shun you. God damn. Whatever. Come on. Please. Let's move forward. You ain't gonna come. Ignore him, y'all. Please. And I'm reading stuff on Facebook, y'all, because people is responding to him. Please ignore him. Please ignore him. So when I would sit up here, I posted this up. So the brother said there's no J's in Hebrew. Right? So I said, well, are you familiar with the Tawahido religion? Tawahido is the original form of Christianity. Right? I asked him that. He didn't respond back to me, but he did this. I'm not going to lie. I'm going to put it up here so y'all can watch it. Right? That's what I asked him. Right? So what happened, I was like, are you familiar with Tawahido? And he pulled out Revelations. Give me 1 second. I'm going to see if I can find it. He pulled out, read Revelations 2:9. That's what he said, read. I said the original Bible was written in Ge'ez. The original Bible was written in Ge'ez. And I told him, go read the Tawahido Bible. That's what I told him, right? Give me 1 second. I'm trying to find it. There it is. That's my comment. I'm going to show y'all what I said to him. Bear with me. This is what I told him. I said, go look up the Tawahido. All of y'all can do y'all due diligence and look up Tawahido, right? That's the original form of Christianity, but we are the original Jews, right? The original ones. So in Hebrew, it may not be a J in Hebrew, but what about Ge'ez? What about Amharic? How about those things? And what defines a J, right? This is me responding to him. I told him, look up the Tawahido. He said, read Revelations. That's what he said, right? You think I don't know about what Revelation says or something? There's a lot of stuff about the Bible I don't get into, but I understand it. You know what I mean? So these are the things that I have to respond to when people leave me comments on Instagram. So I'm going to respond to them. Because some of these people are new. And I said to the brother, if you think I don't know what I'm talking about, you should Google me. This is what I told him. I told him to Google me. Because there's always someone new who comes on. Need more Moors in Lamerck Park with all that black being pushed. I already know. But I said to him, you should research Tawahido and Ge'ez. Or it's pronounced Ge'ez. There is another thing that y'all should watch also. And I don't know if y'all know that Ethiopia is Africa. Ethiopia is Africa.
There's a good movie. Y'all should check it out. It's a long movie. A long movie. The movie is called The Messenger. Go watch this movie called The Messenger. It's an old movie from the 70s, right? When the Jew was sitting with the Muslim. I think it was the Tewahedo Ethiopian Christians, matter of fact, and told them that your religion and my religion is thin as this line. It's all the same once you understand it. So bear with me. So when you sit with these people and get the history lessons, that's a priest. That's an Ethiopian priest giving me history about the original calendar year. He's breaking down the original calendar year, right? As I'm sitting with him. And now he's pointing me out to a book I brought him. This is in Boston. So he's giving me the history of the original languages, all of it, right? Sister Connie, please let him talk. They don't know nothing about me, B. I was home. Please, Connie, don't entertain him. He know nothing about me. If he want to be something, he got receipts on me, then that's all somebody got to do is come on the feed. Please don't entertain him. Whatever he think he got on me, come on the feed. And I'm going to show you how I bust balls. Can't say that. Niggas might want that for real. I don't know nowadays. You got to be careful what you say on this mug, boy, because niggas be liking that kind of stuff. But anyway, let's go back. So this is a little girl who's writing in Amharic. She's from Ethiopia. She's from Ethiopia, writing Amharic. This is what we should be on. She's writing Amharic. But they don't show y'all that because they want y'all to make it like a separate. It's a separate people. No, they're not the same people. Hold up. We're going to go a little further in who the original Jews are. And this is a great book you should pick up by J.A. Rogers. I think this is the one, Nature Knows No Color Line, tomorrow.
Oh, that. Yeah, I've got that book.
The Falasha Jew Students of Ethiopia and their Rabbi Abraham. That's us. I don't know if people know that or not, but Ethiopia is Africa once again. Ethiopia is definitely Africa. So these are the things that we should be teaching our children. Okay? Let's show this. I'm going to show you a little bit more pictures. The birthplace of cultures, all them are called Arabs. All of these people are called Arabs. How did the black Arabs become white? You can go do your due diligence. See, instead of people hating, why don't they get on board with this and show me their receipts? I'm fine if they can come on and show me them. Hey, listen, Bobby Hemmett said, show your receipts. That's what Bobby said. Show your receipts on what we're talking about. I'm fine with it. Because this is the problem. We want to argue religion. Don't realize all religions come out of Africa. All religions come out of Africa. So you can take your pick. Close your eyes.
Yep, they sure do.
Every religion come out of Africa, right? So they got you arguing on who the real Arabs are. And the Arabs is not these people. And Nigga Rabbi Abraham right there. You don't know what religion truly is. This is why you don't have true knowledge of yourself. This is why you're getting played like a damn puppet, because you truly don't have knowledge of who you truly are. It's not complicated. I blame the black teachers. I blame the black scholars. We are the originals of everything, but not this modern day Christianity, because that's not necessarily ours. It is his version of the book. And that version of the Bible is copywritten. That King James version of a Bible is copywritten. If I'm lying, pull it out. I'll give you $500. No lie. I'll cash app it to you, but don't say that. Y'all heard me say it loud, right? So go pull out the King James version of a Bible and tell me if I'm lying. And flip it open like you flip it open a regular book that says it was copywritten.
Oh, man, you about to have me go downstairs, take it off my ancestral altar. But I don't feel like going downstairs.
I wait. It's going to be like this. Copywritten night. This is the propaganda one they're using on y'all. And this is what it says right here. Copyright 1928. That's what the Bible one says. Copyright also. This is Edward Bernays's propaganda book. Copyright. If you don't know what a version is, that's somebody's version. So these books are copywritten. So if the Bible, if I don't think the King James Version, oh, yes, the hell it do. Oh, the King James Version got one. I got a bunch of them. Go look it up. See, this is the crazy part. People don't even know it in this city. Oh, thank you, my sister. Let me help you out. Hold up. This is the funny part. Thank you. We don't even read. That's why we get bit in our behinds. Copyright.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise
him. Hallelujah. I did a dig in for this one. I was like, I know I got it.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. I'm like you, brother. I wasn't going to touch my one that's by my altar right there. So.
Right.
We're going to leave
it. I didn't see a comment. That's why I'm trying to tell you I'm reading multiple things. I'll bear with you. I did see that. I don't think I have a King James Version. I got it. Now I read it. Thank you. So my point is, people, that is their version of the book. I'm not saying anything is wrong if you choose that. But if you believe in a God, why are you worrying about a shot? Why are you worrying about COVID? If you believe in that book, that's all I'm saying. You ain't never hear me praise no book, even though some of these Moors be claiming Islamism. But you ain't never hear me say that either. Just in case, because they swear all Moors are Muslims. Well, that's that Muslim talk. You know, they could be like, that's that Muslim talk. That's that Muslim talk. No, I didn't say that. But that's what they put out there because that's what the media does. They put that out there to y'all. Yeah, that's that. Well, you say more automatically, they go straight to Islam. I'll be like, God damn. You ever notice that? Like when you go straight to Muslim when you say more. But if I showed you this book right here, it says Moorish Jews in it, you'll reject this mug, right? If I showed you in this book from 1800s and it says Moorish Jews, would you believe me? Right? We got to correct the wrong, B. Hold on. Let me help you out. This is the Moor Zionist Temple. Right? Let me help y'all out. That's the Moor Zionist Temple right there. Right? But how many people knew about that in the 20s? But if I take you to history, once again, research. You're right. You can't copyright the word of God. I don't know how people be thinking that, but then again, my bad. This government is their God. My bad. I forgot. Now, I told you I was over there, right? And I was seeing the Moorish Jewish quarters or the Senegalese Jewish quarters. So I'm going to take the picture and I'm going to show y'all in 1 second from the book from the 1800s. Malcolm said, make it plain. Malcolm said, make it plain. Man, we deep in the, my fam said, man, we deep in the rabbit hole. Yeah, we deep, deep. You ever see that? We deep, I'm gonna go deep, deep undercover. Deep Beverly Hills Cops. I'm a movie freak, I'm sorry, y'all. Go deep, 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 deep undercover. So this book was written in 1892. This book was written, Jews of Morocco. So I'm going to just show y'all on here, then I'm going to pick the picture up right here for y'all. Right there. Moorish Jews. I'm going to have some Moors coming at me. Oh, brother, that's not what the prophet brought, bruh. How do you know? You sat in the room with Noble Drolley? Yeah, like they sat in the room with him and stuff, man. Moorish Jews. Like they sat in the room with Noble Drolley. Yeah, man, but the prophet brought us, you know. So this is the Moorish Jews out of the book. You can't play one side of this, man.
We cannot play one-sided. We got to tell both sides of this. She said 100 years of miseducation. You ain't never lied. My people's on Instagram said 100 years of miseducation. And this is why it's hard for us to get out of it. This is why it's hard for us to get out of it. I am not locked in nobody's psychological locks, man. That sound like a Lauryn Hill song. Damn. My brain be going. That's Lauryn Hill. I'm not locked in somebody's box. I'm a free thinker. I will analyze everything. I want you to look somebody up, sister. Tell me if this is true or not. Okay. Could you do me a favor?
Got it.
I want you to look up somebody. I'm gonna put his name in here and I'm gonna show you how they switch stuff up.
Okay.
I love this. I want everybody to Google this. Right? I'm gonna put it in here too. And tell me when you looked it up.
All right, found it.
Okay, now before you do it, I want everybody to look it up. Tell me how it's spelled.
Let's see. I found it. It's spelled with a J.
Oh, really? Really?
Yeah, they changed it.
Are y'all getting this yet?
And B E N.
Are you getting this yet?
Mm-hmm.
Hold up. Are you getting Yahoo? Ibn Tabun? It's with a J. Oh, y'all don't want to hear this. Let me show you who Yahoo the Ibn Tabun is. And guess what he was? He was a Moorish Jew. There you go, right there. This is in Granada, Spain. That's in Granada. That's not over here in the States. That's in Granada, Spain. There you go, right there. Why? Because what happened, you had the Muslims on one end and the Jewish on one end. That where I'm standing at, one way was Jewish, one way was Muslim.
1120. Granada, Spain. Oh, okay. Yeah, 1120 Granada, Spain. A Jewish physician.
Really? How many of y'all knew about him?
I didn't.
You see the shoe I did that on? There you go. It's not a secret who this man is. Hold up. Give me one second. It's not a secret who this man is. But see, our people believe that we are educated and we're necessarily not, right? There you go, right there. This is what real research do. Give me one sec. This is what real researchers do, not pull stuff off of Google, right? There you go, right there again. Yahuda Ibn Tabun. Now I can do a whole lecture just on him alone and what he's done. It's many, many people with him. And if anyone knows about the word Ibn, who knows about what the word Ibn means? Remember what I told you?
I don't know. I forgot.
Me
too. I wrote it all down. It's probably on one of these sticky notes somewhere.
I just told you that. But what is Ibn? You think I don't know what this means? Son, my son's name is Amir. Somebody got a lot of noise, and I think that's you tomorrow. So, my son's name is Amir Ibn Bey, which means the son of Bey, right? So, they took the word Ibn and called it Ben in English, B E N, Ben. As in Benjamin Franklin, which Ben is the son of Jermaine. Benjamin Franklin, son of Jermaine. That's all it means. So I'm sitting here and I'm going through this and I'm like, yo, now you just said Yahuda was Hebrew. So which one is it? Do you get it yet? Mm-hmm. It's the game that's being played on people constantly, because the first thing you have to know is language. And I'm on the ground. I'm in these places. I'm researching it. I need a vacation, B.
That's because I don't talk about it because y'all trying to bait me on these social medias to get it stopped. You can book me. I'm fine. I can break all this down to the very last compound. God damn. But don't try to bait me because you're going to get mad at me and think I'm running and start calling me names and insulting. That shit don't bother me, man. You do your due diligence. Do the research and challenge all of these black scholars. And just get ready for the documentaries because they're coming. Heaviest the Crown is coming. I'm just touching on a little bit in Heaviest the Crown. Imagine when I do my whole piece on Ethiopia. Crazy. I was just sitting outside of a Starbucks out here in Chicago. You know what? The dude said, I asked the dude automatically, where you're from? I said, Somalia. He said, yes. You know what he asked me where I was from? Where you think he asked that from?
Eritrea, Somalia, Ethiopia. Okay, Eritrea.
He said, where are you from, Eritrea? Think about it. See, we don't get this, man, because we're not truly getting educated. And if y'all don't know what Eritrea is part of Ethiopia, which means Red Sea. Eritrea means Red Sea, okay? As Moses parting the Red Sea, you can look up Eritrea. It's going to say Red Sea, and it's part of Yemen. Yemen is right there. There is no such thing as the Middle East. None. No such thing as the Middle East. The middle of what? It's Yemen. Stop. This. Every last one of y'all look like y'all from somewhere on this. I'm dead serious. I'm looking at every last one of y'all on this. I can't tell you where you're from until you open your mouth. If you shut up and just walked, I probably think he's from Sudan. You can look like you could be from Ethiopia. You ever see the people in Ethiopia? They only show you one group of people in Ethiopia. Mm-hmm. Have you noticed that? They show you one part. Now, Sarnetta and them don't want to have this conversation. The Breakfast Club don't want to have this conversation. None of them want to have this type of conversation. Because they always believe that they're going to be ousted or overshadowed like by somebody. No, if you know something, bring it to the people and let them, like in hip hop. In hip hop, you go, they go. And you let the people choose. That's how you do it. That goes for anybody. Moors, Nation of Islam, 5%ers, whatever it is. Educated, Boule people, whatever. Let the people choose. Let the people choose. Because I don't give a damn about how you feel about Sabir Bey. I'm real with it. In person and on here. I'm real. All right. I'm good. So if we're not telling our people this, you're part of that problem. Straight up, you're part of that problem. No lie. If you keep sticking on this whole I'm pro-black African-American bull crap, you're part of the problem. And I hope y'all share this to them because the world is studying you. Everyone's studying you. Everybody's studying you. Give me 1 second. I'm gonna show y'all something. Bear with me. I showed this many times. Many, many times before I showed this video. According to Jesus, your name is Allah, really? As in no time to talk. I don't know what that is. My name? You know something about my name? Shoot, you know about my? Shoot, you said Allah. Give me 1 second. I'm going to play something for y'all. Give me 1 minute. I don't see why people don't get it. My people say, I don't see why people don't get it because they choose not to. They eat poorly, sister. When your pineal gland is calcified, it's hard for you to get this. If your pineal gland is calcified, it's hard. Sheriff, it's calcified. I'm going to play something for y'all. Listen. Listen up.
Utter rubbing, you know.
Listen to this.
Water is a natural enemy of makeup. Anyway.
These are all science projects for your people. Remember his body? The plant, Black Panther.
Oh, yeah.
You see the faces? You see that? Look at his face.
we borrowed our inspiration from the Mercy tribe in Africa.
One more time from the European, y'all. Maybe y'all believe it.
We borrowed our inspiration from the Mercy tribe in Africa.
But you know the Black Panther movie, right? You know the Black Panther movie. Hold up. But they never told you this. They never told you that these are the Mercy tribes in Ethiopia. They never told you that's the Mercy tribe right there. It's Ethiopia. The Mercy tribe. That's Mercy. Look it up. I'll put it in the tag for you. That's the Mercy tribe. You see the dude, you see the faces, you see the marks on their bodies, but they never told you they were Ethiopians. Everybody studies us. Everybody studies us. So they pay their people to go overseas to study. While we sit online talking about we know God. Look up the Mercy tribe. And only way that you would know this if you actually did the research on it. Mercy tribe. In J.A. Rogers' book, he said also that we were Ethiopians and Moors before the 1500s. Ethiopians and Moors before the 1500s. Where is this type of conversation? All Moors were not Muslims. Stop it. They were not. And I challenge any Moor on his feed that want to bring it to the cipher. You were not all Muslims or Muslims, whatever which way you want to bring it. Have your child do a science project on this, man. Let them know, empower your child this way. That's how you empower your child. Empower them to be the better them. That's all. It's not hard. Pick up some books besides certain books that they're talking about. There goes some of my books right there on Ethiopia. I'm going to show you 1 second. There goes some. The best one you can get is 100 Amazing Facts About the Negro. This is a good book on Ethiopia too. So once you understand it, all of it, I don't give a damn. Muslim, Muslims, all the same. Kill that noise with the Muslims and the Muslims. If you're one of those temple Moors, I don't give a damn. It's all the same, period. My point, if you're not hearing me, is that we was not all Muslims or Muslims. That's a fact. If you're in your feelings, I don't give a damn. It's factual. I don't care. You can take it because I know y'all watching it. You got... Okay, I got a couple of more minutes online before I have to get off of here, y'all. Yes, they've been studying us over there for years. For years they've been studying us, and that's why we where we at. I went into a Moor Science Temple one time in L.A., and Karen, my sister Karen, can actually bear witness to what I said. I swear to God, I can't make this up. I did like this inside there. They didn't know what the hell I was doing. I wouldn't know. I'm you laughing, brother. I'm gonna be a buck with you. They didn't know what the hell I was doing. I'm free. I don't have to say Noble Drolley's name 1,000 times, B. I don't have to do that. I don't do stuff like that. I don't worship no man. But I was in that Moor Science Temple. It was on, and anybody from LA know what I'm talking about. It was on Crenshaw. Yeah, Crenshaw. And I went up there and I did like this. They didn't know what I was doing. Nigga, you just gave them the cardinal points. They thought it was some Christian stuff.
Yeah. You probably thought you put roots on them.
So they didn't know what the hell it was. This is the cardinal points. Fire, earth, air, water, winter, summer, spring, fall, north, south, east, west. I gave them the cardinal points. They lost their mind like they wouldn't.
Girl on the mic, you laughing at me, sis. Because they thought he was putting roots on them.
And I'm going to say this before I go. You don't want to test this more right here. I have over 25 years in the game, baby.
Oh, Lord.
25 years and over 20-something years on radio. You don't want to test Sabir Bey. You better go ask your people who Sabir Bey is, okay? Before you test me, okay? I know some of you cats are new. I know that. And this is what I want to respond to my sister too, because she said about Umar Johnson. Let me see if I can find it. She played something with Umar Johnson talking to a European, and Umar said something. Oh my God, let me see if I can find it. And she said, well, what would be the race, Sabir? The race is Asiatic. Asiatic. So that's why I told y'all need to join the band and get on the Asian band on a hate train. Because we all Asians. Noble Juali said it. Elijah told us the whole planet was called Asia. The whole planet was called Asia. I know people are so confused in all of this, man. That's kind of crazy. But let me see if I can play this Umar Johnson piece. Here it is. Can't make this up. This is the funniest thing ever. He need help.
Candace owns the who that?
All right.
We have a white woman on the live.
He said we got a
may
white
I help
woman.
You, young lady?
She's not white.
Okay, how are you?
I'm very well. And you're joining from where?
Australia.
Australia. I've never been to Australia. I'm waiting for my African family to invite me to Australia. May I ask you what brought you to Dr. Umar's live stream?
Dr. Umar's live stream.
What brought me to your live stream?
Yes, ma'am.
Because
my live stream is usually only for African people, and you're not an African. So I was wondering what brought you to
live. Well, I'm trying to be, brother. You know, like I'm doing a solarium. I'm trying to get as dark as I can, but it's just not natural. Stop coming.
You're trying to get dark. May I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Because although a lot of white women get suntan, they never want to be mistaken for a black woman. So can you help me understand that contradiction between wanting the suntan, but never wanting to be mistaken for an African sister?
I want to know, it's really what's the contradiction with him having 5 degrees from the white man? He's want to be unapologetic.
Because we can't get the color that you get. Our pigment, like our pigmentation, will never get to yours, to be the same as yours. Does that make sense?
Right. They said if you go too dark, you might get dirty. But are you aware that the original man and woman of this planet were blue-black? They were as black as midnight. That is the original natural color of humanity.
Are you Christian?
I'm African.
Oh, what's your religious belief?
My religion is revolutionary Pan-Africanism.
Oh, cool. How do we do that? How do I get on
board
with that?
Well, you can't do that because you have to be an African to be a revolutionary Pan-Africanist.
Oh, wow. So that's why everyone's like, wow, why is there a white chick wearing this? I think you're cool as man.
But. Go.
Now, one day.
On. Let me help you out. If all civilization come out of Africa, wouldn't they be African? How about the dark Aborigines? This is the crazy thing, dude. He is a serious problem, dude. Yes, sister say he's an embarrassment. He is an embarrassment. Umar Johnson is an embarrassment, man. And I hope y'all shit is right now. That nigga is crazy. That nigga is out of his mind. He said this is African, but he said the contradiction. But give me the contradiction of being unapologetic, but you cry about having a white man 5 degrees. Somebody help me out. Did y'all shit it to Umar Johnson right now? I know some of y'all got his number. He put his number out so much. That nigga said, tell me the contradiction. But you got the white man degrees. And you said the black people try to take your degree from you. Nigga. Everybody imagines it black, like everybody was really this complexion. How the hell are you a scientist or a scholar and the doctor and you can't know the difference between black because he don't even look like my shirt? How did he know that somebody in her lineage may be dark, dark, dark?
I'm crying.
I mean, somebody shit is to Umar and let him know my number is still the same. And if you want me to show y'all his number, I can show you his number too. My number is the same. You can hit me on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. You can share this to him right now because I'm trying to figure it out. We got to get to the bottom of this motherfucker. Revolutionary Pan. He said revolutionary Pan-African. Whatever the hell that is. That's the crazy part.
I don't get it.
But yet you brag about everybody else and you try to dog everybody else and say they ain't got no degree, but you got the white man's degree, but you're unapologetic. Help me with that one right there. I'm unapologetic African, brother. I'm unapologetic African, brother. I'm unapologetic African. This is crazy as hell. What he was smoking, I don't know. He's smoking on something. He's smoking on his degrees, I guess. That's what that nigga's smoking on. He probably almost out of them motherfuckers. Come on, man. We got to stop, man. So y'all want to see how I respond to these people?
Mm-hmm.
Very diplomatic, right? So y'all can see. I know Umar got this information. That's all he's going to do is do a video and subliminally say my name. He probably going to subliminally say my name, but he can come on the feed every day. If I go overseas and he said he wanted to come on my live, I click that motherfucking live. Straight up. Straight from the door. This is crazy, and we got to stop it, people. We got to stop it. Don't you just love his African accent? Umar Johnson? Somebody said, don't you love Umar Johnson's African accent? I love his African accent.
He ain't got it.
No, he do. No, he got an African accent. My people say, yeah, I want to see that happen. That's all y'all do is all y'all right now flood his piece. And every time he go live, mention my name in his chats and see what happens. Say, talk to Sabir Bey. Talk to Sabir Bey. Talk to Sabir Bey. Irritating. Talk to him. His number. Tell him my number never changed. Every African I know tell me that they're tribal country. Exactly. Ask Umar Johnson what is tribal country. It's unapologetic. Now, Umar ain't worth the time. He's a disappointment. Damn, he's a disappointment. That's a damn shame because he's really playing himself, B. He blamed all of you in the conscious community when the white man wanted to take his degree. Do y'all remember that? He tried to blame all of y'all. He said the black conscious people came to beat me up. Yeah, they was coming to take my... Listen, bro, if it's yours, no one can take something that is yours.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say it again. No one can take anything that is yours. You have to have true knowledge of who you are, and you have to be truthful. I don't know if he's an agent. Somebody said Umar is an agent. I don't know. Maybe y'all should hit him up. I don't know if he's an agent.
No, by the shape of his head,
I think he got trapped in the elevator. You stupid as hell. Doors has you stupid. You are so stupid. But listen, people. If all civilization come out of Africa, then goddamn, we African. Straight up, we African. That's just what it is. If y'all think I'm making things up, y'all can set up a panel wherever you at, your city, your state, your county, your country, whatever it is. I don't give a 747. Where? Set it up. I'm here. And who is this sister? She says she wanted Professor Griffin out to do something. Before I go, who is this person, y'all? Bear with me. Who is Jacob Blake? Jacob Blake. Y'all know who that is?
That's somebody that got killed.
I think the dude got
paralyzed. So many.
Was he paralyzed?
In that, yeah, maybe he was. I don't know. There's been so many.
I think I seen him paralyzed. So somebody just sent me. Somebody posted this on my page. Sonya?
It looks like... The 29-year-old black man that was shot and seriously injured by police officers in Wisconsin, Kenosha, Wisconsin.
Okay, yeah, because she says she wanted to get with Griff and myself to put something together. I'm just saying, who is in on the bucket list? So she wanted to have a bucket, you know, put that together for Professor Griff and myself to speak somewhere. And I would love to do with Griff. I'm supposed to be on Griff's show soon. You know, Griff did tell me he wanted me to come on the show, but we're going to make it happen.
That'd be nice.
All civilization come out of Africa. The whole of Africa was Ethiopia. It's called Ethiopia. The whole of Africa was Ethiopia. Yep. So I hope y'all enjoyed this, man. I really had fun, man. Yeah, really good. Did y'all have fun like I had fun? I really had fun.
Yeah.
Yes.
So share me, do me a favor and share this out. I'm going to do me a favor, share this out. And also go to my Patreon if you want to support me on Patreon. Like I said, I'm because, you know, Facebook, YouTube is tripping now.
They really starting to take stuff down and block stuff. So subscribe to the Sabir Bay Show Patreon. Again, the Sabir Bay Show Patreon. If you love this content, this one, you can also send out, go to Cash App, $SabirBay, and $SabirBay, and Cash App, PayPal, SabirBayRadio@gmail.com. Okay? So I appreciate y'all. Cash App, $SabirBay. PayPal and Zelly is SabirBayRadio@gmail.com and the Patreon. I appreciate y'all. All of y'all that came on the feed, I got to close out with this new track. I don't own the rights to this, but this is my brother Yasin Bey, Most Def. I don't know if you ever heard this before, but it's fire. I'll be jamming off of this. So share it, share it, share it, share it out. Let's go. I thank my panel. Thank my panel. I got to go. Yasin. I against I. I against I. I against I.
My flesh and mind, not my mind. To overcome, but one won't survive. My image is reflecting the enemy's eye, and his image is reflecting mine at the same time. I against I. Flesh in my flesh and mind, not my mind. To overcome, but one won't survive. Right here's where the end gon' start at. Conflict, contact, combat. Fight a sin where the land is marked at. Settle the dispute about who the live is. Three word answer, whoever survived this. Only one of us could ride forever, so you and I can't ride together. Can't live or can't die together. All we could do is collide together. So I'll skillfully apply the pressure. Won't stop until I'm forever. One, a doorstep where death never comes. Spread across time till my time never done. And I'm never done. Walk tall, why ever run? When they move, if I ever come. By my never flex the word. Tell them come, generally, I got started by fire. One, I can't stop. Touch my flesh, your mind, on my mind. To overcome, but one won't survive. My image is reflected in the enemy's eye. And his image is reflected in mine at the same time. I can't stop. Touch my flesh, your mind. In my mind, to overcome, but one won't survive. Survive.